helicopter.
Yeah, I think with the with just the statement of Wanda did nothing wrong. Why Wanda did nothing wrong? I don't think it's possible, because I don't think there's a way that you can contextualize torturing people to be a not bad thing. It's always bad. It might be in a way pragmatically acceptable with liberal use of quotes.
If they're delusional and they just say she had no idea that was happening, and the second she found out that she let him go, they say that, then that means that
which I think people do
she
say,
did something wrong and then backseat on it.
Not even no. In fact, if she had no idea it was happening and as soon as she realized she let them go, I don't think she's morally culpable.
No, because
but that's not what happened.
I think that's. And I think that's different than doing something wrong. You can do something wrong and not be morally culpable for it.
Well, okay, but it sounded like you committed to saying that she was still wrong. What were you committing to?
That she did something wrong?
What does that mean? Like, what are you saying?
I think Wanda did an immoral action.
In the context she has no idea why anything's happening.
You can do, like, see, in this sense, even if, let's say Wanda, like, didn't know that all this was happening, right? She still did something bad.
How would you contextualize that to her from her POV if she has no control over anything that happened?
You can create negative things, like a negative situation or an effect on someone else without knowing it.
You can, but what would have been her wrong act?
The wrong act was, it was wrong to create, to do that to the people, to create that scenario. Which
I don't think that makes sense.
Distinct from, I think it's distinct from her moral culpability.
Well, I think that you've screwed yourself over with words, because the thing is, if I do something like, I don't know, just I'm rolling a ball on a wall back and forth, and then like, I don't know, I get distracted by helping an old lady cross the road, and someone walks by and fucking slips on that ball. Like, if someone said, what was the immoral act? I guess that one's not even applicable, because to an extent, leaving the ball there could be considered irresponsible. But if Wanda literally had nothing, like, she never made any negative choice, it's just something that was brought upon her, I don't see how you could be critical of any of her actions.
Being critical of her action, that's different.
You said she did something wrong.
Yeah, I think that she, you can do something wrong.
She didn't do anything wrong. Something happened to her that was wrong.
Something happened. So in the scenario where something happens to her that's wrong,
yeah,
is she not taking doing anything whatsoever? Because if she isn't doing anything at all,
this scenario is, she's preyed upon by whatever the fuck's going on with her magical mind-melting stuff, to the point where she gets, like, if you remember, the idea with the argument to defend her is that she's just as much a victim of it as everyone else in Westview.
But that's not even, you can't even remove that from, you could still, that, I don't even see how that would, I guess it depends on the specifics, because you can still be a victim in that scenario, but be taking actions that can prolong it.
So what I'm, the whole premise of this is that the people who defend her will argue that she didn't do anything. It was all put upon her, just like the people there, by the uncertainty and the untenableness of whatever the Scarlet Witch curse arguably is. Yeah, like, I don't even think chat are understanding what I'm saying. I'm not talking about what happens in WandaVision. That's the response to the people making this argument. However, this argument gets made by people because they ignore elements of the show.
In terms of isolating her, like, moral culpability for it, we'd have to sort of know how she recognizes its existence. And even if there was a scenario where, yeah, I guess it would depend on how you'd be able to frame it. But I remove something's effects from someone's, like, their responsibility for it and their, like, moral standing as a result of it.
Yeah, so the premise that I was providing was that she didn't choose to do anything. It just happened this way, and she's just as much a victim as everyone else would be. The thing is, that's not what happened. That's not what we were shown. If you remember, that's something that we were hoping they would contextualize it as. But they didn't. They said that she chose to do this, and then when she recognized that she was torturing people, she didn't care. So that's why she did was wrong, while in the scenario people will defend her for, there's nothing she did. is something that happened.
Maybe that's the confusion, is the fact that this is based on a scenario that we never saw. Like, it's,
well, that was my
like,
premise. That's what people say. Like, if you murdered someone while sleepwalking, you did something wrong. That doesn't mean it was your fault. I don't even know that you can say someone did something wrong, as opposed to, I don't even know what that would be classified under, like, with law, if it were proven that it was done in sleepwalking.
I would agree with a super chatter, but yeah, there's definitely a difference between your response, like you being held responsible for something that you did when you weren't able to either, like, you know, choose it in a way that is typical when someone's lucid. Yeah, those are two different things. And I don't actually know what would happen legally in a situation like that.
Well, if you could prove, a lot of people in chat were bringing up like involuntary, like,
negligent homicide or manslaughter, yeah, like, usually.
But the idea would be that with those, you've done something wrong. Your intent wasn't to do that specifically, but there was some failing on your part that caused it. Whereas the Wanda one, the point that's trying to be made by people is she had absolutely zero intention or zero capability of either controlling it or preventing it or being aware of what she did. And so the nature of like, well, how responsible can you hold her? It's like, I don't know, like, I guess it'd be really hard to say much at all if she has absolutely zero idea that it happened or how to stop it.
Yeah, out of curiosity, would you say that Bucky did something wrong, Rags?
When he did what?
As Winter Soldier. It did...
Yeah.
Wow, okay. This is like, I just, I wouldn't reconcile it that way at all. I would be like, no, he didn't do anything wrong, it wasn't even him.
Oh, well, I guess I just see those as completely different things to me. I just categorize those as they're just,
it's whoever's occupying the body, like, it's the body's actions is how you see it, is it?
I would say in that, sort of. But, I mean, even if... I mean, it depends on... Because he can do something wrong, but other people can also do things wrong, and his responsibility for those things is totally removed from that. Sometimes they're linked, sometimes they're not.
So what about a robot?
I don't know.
If a robot does something wrong, you would say the robot did something wrong as opposed to the person who programmed it?
I don't know. I haven't given it. I just don't know.
I feel like that's an easy
question. Is it not a completely apt comparison? Because the robot and Bucky have zero agency. The agency would be ascribed to the people who made
them. Yeah, no one says the Terminator's doing things wrong. It's like, well, it's not a... it doesn't have any agency. It's the person who made it.
Yeah, I'd certainly say that the people who programmed and, like, forced him to do that are certainly doing bad things and should be held responsible for it.
You wouldn't say that the robot did something bad. You would say that the person who made the robot do it did something bad, right? Like,
I would say that the robot did something bad.
But the robot is a tool. It would be like saying that a knife did something bad because it stabbed someone when a person did it. The person is always the person who is responsible for the bad act, not the tool or the mechanism by which it comes about.
I think that a bad thing can result from a natural process.
Yeah, sure, but like, but you wouldn't like ascribe any culpability to like the process though, right?
No. So in the same way that I wouldn't hold like Bucky responsible for it, in a moral way.
What if he described as he did something wrong, but he's not responsible? Would you not just be like, well, the person who made him do it did the wrong, like they did something wrong?
Yeah, they're the one who should be accountable for it. Yeah.
Well, yeah, but I guess I'm just confused by the like terminology. That's all. I guess it's just when we say that like something is wrong that's happened, generally it feels like it's going to be about like
something bad like, happened, yeah. Seems like the better way to classify
a hurricane is something bad that happens. You don't really say like a hurricane is wrong. It's like a bad thing that happens.
That hurricane did something bad. It didn't do something wrong.
Right, but that's... So, but you would say that for the robot?
I don't know.
Okay, well, because, yeah, the way I would break it up is just depends on their ability to even take action at all. Or, like I said, with the ball example, that there is a tiny form of negligence there that I think is enough for me to say you did something wrong by rolling the ball into place and not taking care of where it is. But a robot or a hurricane or a knife, I would just be like, they are an extension of the person who's acting, or in the case of the hurricane, it's just nature, and that's an unfortunate thing. But I'd still describe each of those events as, when a Terminator kills someone, it's, you know, something fucking horrible happened as a result of someone, whoever made the robot, but I wouldn't say that the Terminator did something wrong. Doesn't really make sense to me. That's why I'm saying this on behalf of Wanda.
Yeah, I would have to, I guess I'd have to really think more about the distinction between bad and wrong and that sort of thing. And I guess I hear them and I think that they're similar but not the same. I don't know, I just haven't thought about it much.
A couple people are like, ugh, semantics. It's like, yeah, semantics. That's what that was. I find it interesting. A lot of miscommunication will come down to semantics. So, how we use words. Good old language. But the point I was making was that that's what Wanda Stans will typically argue. It was out of her control. She should not be blamed for it.
You would have to definitely present an entirely different scenario to what we saw in the show to portray
absolutely.
Hers.
The show doesn't present what it believes it presents. Like,
it's one of those, this is a consequence of bad writing, is that it's not just that things don't make sense sometimes, or that we get some, you know, this, that, and the other thing, but it really does have these sort of, it's like dominoes. When you accidentally write this thing bad, it is going to lead to something else, and lead to something else, and then when you get enough dominoes down the line that we kind of have now with Marvel, you don't know where the blame always lies. Is this just a product of bad writing that's not intentional? If it's still bad, what's in the movie still in the movie, how long can we go without acknowledging it? Should you never acknowledge it? Should you? And what are you going to say? What's the in-universe reason for it if it's bad writing? It can be confusing, and there might never be an answer because of how muddled it gets.
Mm. And if you remember, if there were a mini series for us reacting to WandaVision, it was episode 4, the scene happened.
I think five was the scene where I'm not the one with pointing the guns, which was a really great retort to a very valid point.
No, it's not the only scene that destroyed her character in the show, but it was, I think, the first proper definitive, like, oh shit.
Oh, she knows what she's doing. Oh no. And then, of course, it all dovetails wonderfully with "They'll never know what you sacrifice for them," which, like, that's you can't have this line in the same scene when you've got like a woman there saying, "Hey, can I please see my child? I haven't seen them for weeks. I just want to know if they're okay." While I am temporarily pulled out of your spell that has stripped me of my capacity to choose, like, possibly, like. We talk about violations of, like, basic humanity. Like, holy shit. Oh, and then the woman who said, "Can you just kill us, right? Like, if you won't let us live, just let us die." Oh my god. Why would you write this and then have her still be the good guy?
I need to use the loo, and I'm going to grab a drink while I do, so before we get into it. So I'll be right back. Try to be quick.
No problem.
Do you mind if I just chime? Oh no, go on.
Sorry, go ahead.
I was just going to say, I took a look at the description for this video because I wanted to try and work out whether it was a joke or not. I don't think it is. And just reading through the description, because they basically give a very long description about what their argument is. This might be a bit of a spoiler for the video, but it seems that this person is going to take the position that, not that Wanda didn't know what she was doing, but that she knew what she was doing, and she was conscious of her actions, and she was in control of it, but she didn't think that she was hurting anybody. So she didn't think she was doing anything wrong.
So, well, I guess we'll get there in the video, but the quick version is, I would argue that that isn't representative of every piece of information we get in the show, but even if that were the truth, you've taken the ability to act, the ability to choose from everyone there, which is already just wrong.
That's already an incredibly massive breach. You know?
I was trying to think of what's the word for that, like, because slavery be suitable, or is it slaves to like?
I mean, it's slavery.
I guess it is in the sense that you're forcing people against their will to do something.
Even if it, like, is happy, you know. Well, she thinks it is.
Well, so the main, well, it's like, the reason why slavery is bad is because you strip people of their autonomy. Autonomy is like something that's super duper important, as like a, you know, your capacity to make choices. And Wanda's is like significant in that it's your mind. It's not even that you're being compelled to do things against your will with threats of violence. It's like you are incapable of making choices. Yeah. Your mind has been compromised.
It's almost like being a puppet.
Yeah, basically. It is basically a puppet. You're a puppet, and you know, you think about the wrong there. It's like, imagine the trauma that you have as like a normal person in the Marvel universe that like one of the heroes, the Avengers, has the capacity to just like strip you of your humanity, and then she flew away instead of like facing any level of accountability. She's still out there. Trauma, like we talk about the amount of trauma that's been dealt to these people, significant, like very significant. And it seems like the show isn't even fully aware that that's what's happened. That like we have an entire town that this town's probably done, like destroyed, and all of the people in it like got a lot that they're gonna have to deal with over the course of their lives. So that's kind of irreconcilable for the fact that there is somebody who exists in the universe who can just strip you of your capacity to choose and act, and then got away with it. You know, like damn. And that you have to try and explain this to your kids who are also victims of this too. It's like, yeah, it's actually pretty horrible. The show doesn't really want to meaningfully acknowledge how awful this is as like a thing that's happened.
See, from watching, like the way that I interpreted it when I was watching the show is I got the impression that she knew that she was actively doing something. She knew that she had created that situation in some way, and she was deluding herself about it and deluding herself that she wasn't doing anything wrong and wasn't hurting anybody. She just didn't want to admit it to herself. That was the impression that I got.
I don't think the show did a very good job of translating that fully. They especially were missing a scene where she would have said, like, I'm providing, like, they are happier than they will ever be. But even then, we're in a position of, like, ooh, you're giving them the happiness you know they want.
That's not your choice, you know?
Yeah, and then there's the just let us die thing, like...
I don't know why they put that in.
Well, was it her or Vision that spotted the person on the outskirts who was literally crying as they tried to just peg something to a line over and over again?
I think it was Vision.
Man, that shit is just terrifying. Like, you're just trapped in that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that is the confirmation that she didn't even care to check what's up with everybody here. She just assumes it's all fine, don't worry about it, which is already in and of itself fucked up.
Well, imagine if the story was herself coming to realize, wait a minute, like, a TV show, and then she starts, like, trying to figure out what's happening. She doesn't even understand how it's possible that it happened. Like, she discovers these things.
I think the way to go would have been that she thinks they're not real. She thinks they're all made up.
Yeah, that probably is the best thing that she could have done. But, yeah. And then, of course, when she figures out and there's level of responsibility, like, don't fly away, all right? That's like the... She can't fly away. That can't happen.
Remind me.
So I... Yeah?
I was just going to say about the kids. Because I remember that we end up seeing... some children at some point, right? But even Vision says, why are there no children? Has she locked them away in their rooms and then hopes
I think that's
arguably worse.
Yeah.
Because at least the others have to simulate living a life, which I think is better than standing still in a room doing nothing, right? But, because I don't think we ever found out exactly what she was doing with them, because we have that thing where it's like, please let me see my kids or whatever. And so it's like, I don't think anyone gets to confirm what the state of the kids are, but that's arguably horrifying.
Especially if they're like banging on the door or something in there and you can't get to them. That's gotta be like, Jesus fucking Christ.
She only let them out for Halloween. Like, what are we dealing with? You know, like.
That almost seems to me like the writers had an awareness of like, oh yeah, this is horrible. It's like, but out of sight, out of mind, right? Like, you can't see them. You can't think about them.
I'd also like to point out that Jay messaged me. He said he does agree with me. The Matthew Broderick films being next to each other is a little strange. Now that we've just confirmed
I'm glad that you felt the need to say that. It's not embarrassing at all.
It's not embarrassing when Jay agrees with you. It just proves that you're correct. But yeah, that settles that. We can move forward with that issue.
I like how it went from, that's just my creative thing I had. And I was like, now that we proved that I'm correct.
It is an objective aspect of the fabric of the material universe. Yes, it is. So,
we're going to do an EFAP about ego one day, and it'll be enlightening. We got all experts on this panel, I'm sure.
I have all, Jay and I will have all the taste, and we'll let you know how the world should be. That'll be great.